Crane Chicago Business last week reported the Bears will soon unveil plans for a new dome stadium along the lakefront in which they would invest millions of their own money through private financing for construction and public amenities, but with proposed infrastructure enhancements to benefit access to the stadium and museum park campus, which would require hundreds of millions in taxes. State Representative Kam Buckner oversees the district that includes Soldier Field and the lakefront and is already expressing support for a project whose cost, when all is said and done, will likely be in the $2.5 to $3 billion range. And the representative joins us now in tonight's Gimme 5. Kam, thanks for joining us here. And first question is, have you seen or are you anticipating what this reported dome stadium proposal will include and look like?
So I'm waiting to see this. I've had a number of conversations with the Bears organization about the things that they are working on. I have not personally laid my eyes yet on what this proposal looks like, but I'm looking forward to it. I want to see what they're talking about, what they're thinking about. And to me, this proposal, as it's forthcoming, is really the overture that folks like me need to hear to know that the Bears are serious about Chicago. What I've said in the past, Chris, is that we need the Bears to much like Dorothy in the Wizard of Oz, realize that there's no place like home. And then we can start having real conversations about what's next.
All right, well, the tough questions will come immediately. Why do you believe this is a good idea for the citizens of a city who don't want to pay more taxes, or at least don't want taxes they currently pay to be diverted from needs that remain underfunded for something, you know, they really won't benefit from for several years down the line?
Yeah, I've been very clear about this, about the way I feel about public financing for private stadium development. I think it's been problematic. In fact, you didn't see much of it until the 1950s, and when it happened, it began to boom around the country. Things have started to change, which is the right thing to do. I don't think taxpayers should be on the hook. In fact, the Bears deal from 20 years ago, to me, still today remains problematic, as the people of Chicago still owe $500 million on that debt obligation. What I've said is that if we can find creative ways to create public-private partnerships that benefit the people of Chicago, then we should have thorough conversations about what that looks like. I'm not willing to say that, you know, there should be a blank checkbook at any level of government. I also want to hear exactly what this proposal looks like so we can protect the people of Chicago and Illinois. This cannot just be about the next football season. This cannot be just about the next Super Bowl. It has to be about the next generation and not shouldering them with that debt.
So strictly from a Bears stadium standpoint, how do you envision this working financially? I know you've mentioned a co-op between ISFA and McPeer, the Metropolitan Pier and Exposition Authority, as well as you mentioned a privately used VIP access road between Randolph Street and McCormick Place as being crucial to kind of tying this all together.
Yeah, I think there are a number of things we have to look at. We have the opportunity here to be creative. And I say we because I think the Bears have to work with the city and the state in order to do this, right? There is the availability, hopefully, of owner capital and secure loans on the private side. We have to talk about what that looks like. The NFL has a stadium loan program called the G4 program that they use for their member organizations. How much can be taken out of that to work for this? And then, you know, we've got to tie in things like transit. We can't talk about building a new stadium on the lakefront without having real conversations about how you move people around and traffic studies and bringing in analysts who can actually look at the data to figure out how we move forward. And so I'll go one step further. I think the Bears need to commit to a lot more for the city as well. I want the mayor and the city council to push the Bears to talk about whether or not they can move their actual headquarters, their facilities from Lake Forest here to the city of Chicago. We have a chance to do things that are big and bold and brave and different. We just got to start pushing.
You have been quoted as saying if the Bears don't want to marry Chicago, they can't date other people. There remains, you know, the widespread belief that their heart and their eventual destination is Arlington Heights as they negotiate to get, you know, a better property tax situation after paying nearly, $200 million for the old racecourse site where more money from that development would likely go directly into their pockets. How much do you believe the city could be being used as a bargaining chip in all this?
I think it's possible, right? This is business. And many times in business, people, they link and they leverage and they align and try to find ways to use one opportunity to get a better opportunity in another space. But this is why I've started this interview and I start most conversations about this. But the first step in this is the Bears coming to the city of Chicago and the people of Chicago and saying, we want to be here. We're going to stay here. And, you know, as far as Arlington Heights or other places are concerned, we have to, I think, at some point end those conversations if we're going to have robust conversations and a solid plan on what's going to happen moving forward.
Are the Bears a higher priority than the White Sox, who, you know, they have themselves what's an acceptable 34-year-old facility with an owner who has, you know, kind of alienated a portion of his fan base with how the club has been operated in recent years and is now using the phrase staying competitive to convince the city and state to help build that stadium in the South Loop, which would be less than a mile away from the current and any future Soldier Field. Are the Bears a priority amongst the two?
Well, the thing about working in government and running government is that all things are important, right? And so I'm very reticent to try to pit the White Sox against the Bears. What I've said is this is like trying to make a parent pick who their favorite child is. I think the right thing to do is to have a real plan for both of them and to hear what both these organizations, both the Reinsdorf family and the McCaskey family, have in store. We should sit down and figure this out together, as I think the Senate president has talked about. I've said these are two separate wheels, but they're spinning on the same axis, right? And so as far as priority is concerned, the priority is the people of Chicago. The priority is the people of Illinois and the taxpayers.
I actually do have one more question for you, and maybe it's the toughest one of all. You played ball at Morgan Park and University of Illinois. So my question is, Justin Fields or Caleb Williams?
I knew that was coming. I'll say this, man. I'm a loyalist, right? And so I believe in loyalty. I think Justin Fields really has shown this organization who he can be if you put the right tools around him. I think for far too long in his very early career, he hasn't had the right tools. And so this is a tough draft for them. I think Caleb Williams is going to be a great player in the NFL, but I think Justin Fields is a generational quarterback. He's my guy. I hope he stays here, but only if we surround him with the right tools. I like Marvin Harrison III.
All right, Kam, thanks a bunch for taking some time. We appreciate that and sharing some of your insights and thoughts. And we're all curious to see if, how, what, and when things will or will not happen. State Representative Kam Buckner joining us here on GN Sports. Thanks again.
Thank you.